Thank you. personality when they like animated Lady. They did a good job. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with my concealer. I think that the Cinderella movie, the live action one, I love that movie. Like, that's my favorite live action princess movie, is the Cinderella one. I love her dress. Like, that dress is what dreams are made of. And then I also really like the live action Beauty and the Beast. I love how they portrayed Beast in that one. I love that he's like not as goofy as they usually make him. I don't like picture him being goofy, so whenever they like portray him as like a big dumb like lug type of person, I'm like, I don't know, I don't buy it. But in the live action one, he's like super smart and he's read like every book in the library, and he's, you know, it's easier to imagine her actually falling in love with him because he's got like an actual personality versus, you know, sometimes he's portrayed like just kind of like a bumbling idiot, and then you're like, okay, hard to see how she would fall in love with him when he has like no personality. Let's see, I also love The Rescuers. I like The Rescuers and The Rescuers Down Under, but I prefer the Rescuers, the first one, with Penny. She's so cute. Madame Medusa is like one of my favorite Disney villains. I think she's really good as like a villain, you know. And then I also love Yzma. Yzma is like my number one favorite villain. She cracks me up. And let's see. Yeah, so Emperor's New Groove is way up there. We watch that movie like frequently. I think that one is so perfect for just kind of like having on in the background, and it's light and funny. Yzma like all the time. She's definitely my favorite villain. Let's see, and then I also love Princess and the Frog. That one is so good. Vasilier is also like a good villain. I really like him. Super creepy. Those voodoo spirits or whatever they are, come take him wherever they're taking him, the underworld, I assume, I don't know. And Lottie, yeah, she's great. I love her pink dress so much. Let's see, I'm gonna do sworn that I saw it on there though, but Disney movie. Oh, and then, okay, the movie Balto. Oh my gosh. I love that movie. So, my very first dog, we got a dog. I think I might have been like 5 years old. I wouldn't quote that though. I don't know exactly how old I was when we got her, but I was pretty young. And we got a golden retriever, and I named her Jenna after one of the dogs in Balto. Yeah, I love that movie. And what were the polar bears? Were they Muck and Luck? Oh, I love them. I love the polar bears. That's a great movie. I haven't watched it in a while. I would like to watch that. It's kind of funny that I named my dog after a dog in that movie and then ended up living in Anchorage, Alaska for a while. I did get to visit Nome, where that movie mostly takes place. They have a Balto statue there at the airport, and then there's also a Balto statue, in New York City in Central Park. I got to see that one too. I made sure I got to go check both of those statues out. I have a picture somewhere. Yeah, I love that. The pronter is just, I don't know, it's not going right. In that movie, and then also the horse, and I don't know why his name is escaping me right now. That's gonna drive me nuts. Maximus, that's what it is. I just remembered. So yeah, Rapunzel and Maximus are my favorite characters in Tangled. Not Disney, it's an old live action movie. But I could watch that movie just over and over and over again. I love Clue so much. So then I also love the movie Murder by Death. It's another old movie that's just kind of really like dumb humor. It's light and you know, you don't really have to pay attention, and it's just something to kind of have on in the background. I've seen it so many times now, like I don't even have to watch it really to know what's going on. Okay, next is Blush. This is the elf one. It's always cheeky. Let's see, what other? Oh, Swan Princess. Yes, that's not a Disney movie either, but oh my gosh, I used to watch that movie all the time when I was a kid. I love the name Odette. It's so unusual and pretty. Oh, that's such a good movie. I wish I could watch that. I wonder, I don't remember if I have it on DVD. I think I might. Our DVDs are still not unpacked yet. They're like in a big box in the basement, so I might have to root through there and see if I can find it. So, highlighter next. this one. I haven't used this in a while. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder, and it's in the shade Flower Crown. It's like a gold, gold highlighter. Boy, the 4K really picks up the dust flying around in here. This house was unoccupied for like almost 2 years before we bought it. So like we're still trying to get, you know, the dust out of here. Like I have an air purifier. I run it, like I move it around all the rooms. I run it like all the time trying to get the dust. And like when we first moved in, it was really dusty. There was so much cleaning and yeah, it's just what happens when houses are unoccupied for a long time. Okay, so I'm gonna use the Milani Gilded Flora palette again. I think I wanna do like a pinky, peachy pinky purple type situation. I'm just gonna kinda go for it, but I'm gonna go into the creamy white shade first and just kinda set down the concealer. And that one is called Fresh as a Daisy. So then next I want to go in with like a transition shade. So I'm going to use this peachy shade at the bottom called Best Bud. And I put my nail in it. In the crease and kind of all over the lid as well. Let's see what other movies. Oh, I love The Sound of Music. That one's so good. We used to watch that all the time at my grandma's house, like in the summer or during the holidays when all the cousins were together. That was really fun. And the other one we loved to watch at Grandma's house was The Secret Garden. That one is really good. I'm just trying to darken this up a little. My favorite character in The Secret Garden is Dickon. I like his sister Martha too. They're both really cool. So let's see. I'm gonna go next into the shade called My Pretty Peony. It's that like bright pink right in the middle. This is going how I was hoping. I like the way the orange looks under the pink. Let's see. Oh, I love the movie Monsters Incorporated. My favorite character is Sully. And then I also love Ross. She's funny. We used to have a, what they call a scheduler at the airline. This is the person that calls you to give you your trip or to let you know of any changes in your schedule, stuff like that. And she sounded just like Roz. It was so funny. I always loved when I would get her calling me because she would make me laugh. She'd be so like monotone and like grumpy sounding. She's actually super, super nice lady, but she'd always just have such a like, I don't know, like Eeyore sounding voice. Everything was very like, subscribe. Okay, so last thing, I'm gonna go into the color bokeh. That's this one. And I just wanna kinda put that all over. I should do it with my finger, but let's see. I'm gonna try not to get it all over my under part of my eye because I keep versus the Machines, and that was really cute. I wasn't expecting it to be so good, but I really loved it. And then the other movie, this is a Christmas movie, but it's animated. It was Klaus. That's on Netflix too, and I love that so much. What is the little girl's name? I could remember. But they build her like a sled with a, like a wind sail on it, and she's like sailing around in the snow, and she's so cute. I think that movie is great. Okay, I'm gonna go in with the Elf Lash and Roll mascara. I said that really weird. Mascara. Just filling in. stringy when you pull it out of the tube. But it's so pretty. I love this one. Yeah, this one is definitely one of my top lip glosses. Okay, and then I just want to deal with my brows a tiny bit. I'm gonna brush them. Should get better at doing my brows. I just really don't want to mess with it.